Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome back for another Dragon Ball Legends video. Today we're going to be talking about the new 1.9 update that came out. And with that, we actually got a whole bunch of awesome information. Let's go over here, jump into this. First off, update announcement for today, 7-4. By the way, guys, happy 4th of July, happy America Day. You know, go out, barbecue, have some beers, and enjoy the day. Well, maybe if you're lucky, you can watch some fireworks. I know we're supposed to be getting some thunderstorms here in the Northeast, so hopefully everything else works out for all of you. Anyway, with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the news update. Also, I will be doing my weekly grind later on today. Update contents. You can now check your summon history from the menu. You will go to the menu, go to Other, then there will be a summon history there. You can now check out your party details from the character and edit screens. PvP matches are now made more quickly, which is awesome, because let me tell you, trying to wait 30 to 40 seconds, while it doesn't seem like a lot, is a pain in the butt. And an opponent who is more closely matches your strength, which means you will not be getting matched up with people who are so much more OP than you. I mean, I'm okay with it because I have pretty much the very OP characters. My team's pretty much 100% in the first two slots for each of them, and then the third slot, I'm like working my way through it. So, yeah, it's pretty damn awesome for me when I go up against like one person who has one unit. But anyway, status condition icons have the below designs. Effects remain the same. So, it's just changing them so that way there it looks like it's a diamond shape instead of like a bad shape, I guess. The actual pictures remain the same though. So there's that. Additionally, the following issues have been fixed. Let's see. When changing cover, buff icon does not display correctly. When both sides use a special move and trigger Dokkaebaki impact, the key gauge is not used up correctly. I didn't realize that special moves trigger Dokkaebaki impacts, because I have used special moves before, and when at the same time, they just kind of cancel each other out. The only thing is the melee attacks, unless a special move is considered melee attack, but I don't think so. I'm pretty sure it's like the Kamehameha wave. Chrono Crystal received for friendship level 11 plus do not display correctly. Correct amount of Chrono Crystals are received, though, so that means you are getting them at least. The main storybook 5, chapter 8, some devices do not go to the result screen after defeating Raditz with a special effect. Okay, interesting. With certain commands, the effect of cover sustained damage cut remains after changing cover. Ooh, that's actually awesome. I wish they didn't fix that. Set timer counts in certain missions do not function correctly for some users. Missions are shown as completed upon login, and rewards can be received. So that's interesting. Actually, some of that does make sense, though. I guess you have to go and finish to actually collect the rewards in the adventure. I know I logged in today. I collected my adventure rewards. It said I completed the daily mission, but I didn't get it. I have to go redo it. We are going to jump into the game, too, in a little bit as well, because I want to go over all the missions and whatnot. Although I could kind of do it here on the video on the website. Let's see. So that's pretty much everything that's been fixed for the update. And this is also an addendum over here. Confirmed in-game issues as of today. We've confirmed the existence of the following issues and now are investigating. When selecting multiple boost panels and soul boosts, an error message containing conditions have not been met may pop up and send players back to the title screen. It's pretty much saying do one at a time. So, like back in the old days of Dokkan Battle, when you use potential orb system, you could only do one node at a time. That's pretty much what they said. If that happens, just do it like that. And that's kind of a pain in the butt. So, yeah. I mean, whatever. What can you do? It didn't happen to me today when I went and I bought my Vegeta pack. So, but if you guys had run into that problem, apparently that's what you need to do. Daily missions upgrade campaign. So if you guys aren't aware, we do have the new Trunks and the new Vegeta. They are available on the banner as well as the Kid Gohan. He's on that banner as well, which is kind of cool because I didn't pull the Kid Gohan, though I wasn't really trying to. Honestly, out of all of them, I wanted the Vegeta. And since he was a pack, I didn't really have to worry about it. Trunks is cool too, but I really like the Vegeta. The Vegeta is actually really freaking good. But we're going to talk about him in a minute. We have the daily mission rewards, and pretty much, I'm not going to go over everything, I'm just going to go over the daily mission one. You have Chrono Crystals, Skip Tickets, Zenny, Crate of Milk Bottles times 3, Rare Metals times 50, Rising Soul 1 Red, 2 Red, and Super Soul 1 Red. You also get this Ultra Summon Assist ticket, number 2. Pretty much what's going on with this is, you have to play, get a total of 14 of these guys, and every 7 of them, you get a free Sparking Unit. So this is going on for 2 weeks. Log in every day. Do your daily logins. When you do your daily login bonuses, you're going to get one of these tickets. And 7 tickets gives you a Sparking character. So go ahead, log in, do your daily missions. They are not that hard. You can do them usually within 10, 15 minutes. And just it's awesome because you're getting free Sparkings. This game is so much better so far in terms of helping out the community stay competitive. So far at least. It's only been, about a month and a half. But this is pretty awesome. And this is going to go on for a while, and you get a whole bunch of awesome items. I'm not going to read through all of them. And then you go and get your Ultra Summon ticket, and it's for the actual banner that has the Kid Gohan, Vegeta, Trunks, Super Saiyan Goku, and Pan. So that's pretty damn awesome. I'm really liking that. I'm digging that. But yeah, that's available. So definitely log in and do your daily missions. News. The Advent of Frieza, the Universal Emperor event, is now on. So pretty much just like the Ginyu event, just log in there, go ahead and play. Just do it. You get your crystals, do all the missions, you get a whole bunch of cool mission rewards. I'm not going to go over everything. We got some new items. We got the Vegeta item over here. It's like a bronze, so it's not like it's going to do a lot of damage or do a lot of buffing. Base health up to 10%. Base strike up to 7.5. And base blast defense up to 7.5. I don't think it's worth it. But, I mean, who knows? It might be something good in the future. Or maybe, I'm just lying. It's not. Next, we got the Frieza one over here. Pay in full for this. Insects. Slot 1, base blast attack up to 12.5%. Base blast defense. Up to 10% and base critical up to 3%. The one thing I need to hit up Renzi about, because we don't have who these attach to. Sometimes they have specials, like only get attached to Frieza or yellow characters or blue characters. We should get that information put up over on here. Next one is going to be the Piccolo one. Piccolo item, Fury of the Namekians, base blast defense up to 12.5, strike defense up to 10, and critical up to 3%. That's not that good in my opinion. Then you have Frieza second form. Oh, look at that. He's holding up two. So the second one is base blast attack up to 12.5, strike attack up to 10%, strike defense up to 10%. Not bad. Honestly, the thing is the Ginyu items went up to like 15 to 20%. And I made sure I got like all the ones I kept went all the way up there. The thing is they were only specific to those units. I wonder if these guys are going to be specific to like Frieza first, second, third, fourth, final form, right? Third form is blast attack up to 12.5, blast defense up to 10, and 2 to 7.5% damage due to regeneration. Wow, what's that? Damage to regeneration. Oh, okay, more damage to low. So people like Piccolo, because Piccolo has the tag regeneration, that's why. Beyond the Horrors of Hell. Wow, that's awesome. I love that title. Blast attack plus 12.5%, strike defense up to 10%, ultimate damage plus 7.5%. That's awesome. And well, holy crap, we have so many of these damn items over here. Goku, blast attack, strike attack, 12.5 to 10%, strike defense, 10%. Krillin, 12.5% blast attack, 10% strike defense, and critical up to 3%. Oh, look, we have some gold items up in here now. That's awesome, hell yeah. Please lend me your energy. Base strike attack plus 15%, blast attack plus 12.5%, and up to 7.5% damage to Frieza Force. That's awesome. You're going to be doing so much more damage with that guy. The Frieza one, thought I'd let you get away. 15% to blast attack max. Blast defense up to 12.5%. Key restore speed. I love those key restore speeds up to 5%. That's freaking phenomenal. And Super Saiyan Goku, Angry Super Saiyan, 15% strike attack. 12.5% strike defense. Key restoration speed up to 5%. Each slot is guaranteed to have one ability assigned to it, obviously. To unlock two, you need to upgrade your equipment. So, yeah, that's pretty damn awesome. Holy shit. So this is going to be a really good event. I am definitely going to be grinding it. I think each of these are probably going to be based off of the Goku, the Frieza, and the Super Saiyan Goku cards. I'm not sure yet. I'll definitely talk about that when I find out about it. I'll do a video. We also have the Scout Battle for Paikuhan. He's really good. Honestly, I would recommend going and grinding him out. Honestly, hero cards like this for Scout Battles, they're really only useful for their Z abilities for the most part, unless you don't have any really good units, if you got shafted. But at that point, if you've gotten shafted and you don't have any good units, honestly, just reroll your account. But anyway, Z ability, when he gets up to Z ability 3, 20% to element green base strike defense during battle. So he's going to be really good when going up against, or when he's on the same team as Piccolo. So if you're trying to buff up your Piccolo, you could throw that 20% defense, 20% strike defense on here for him. So just throw him on a team. You don't have to actually play with him. If you want to, you can. He's decent, or he's a hero, but 40% to own critical damage. Yeah, I don't like that, the critical damage thing. Key form of attack, 10% to own strike damage for 20 counts. Not bad. Unique ability, anti-Frieza Force, 10% strike damage inflicted against tag Frieza Force. We have the summons that are available, and this is kind of what I know of a lot of you guys were waiting for. Ultra Space Time Summon number 2 is now on. That's for the Trunks and the Vegeta that are available. Now, I personally love this Vegeta. By the way, I did say that the Vegeta pack was here available in the shop if you want to pick it up for $24 or $24.99, I think it was. Didn't they go up by a dollar? I think it went up by a dollar, which is freaking crazy because, like, come on, stop doing that kind of shit. Anyway, the Super Saiyan Vegeta, this is his card. This is his stats over here. I still am trying to get a grasp of his stats when what they all mean and everything. But this is basically what his stats are right now. So health is 19.59k, strike attack is about 15, blast attack is 1460, strike defense is 1551, and blast defense is 1076. Key restore speed is actually a little bit higher. Higher end is 2285, which is awesome. So I don't know what these are. I think this is the levels, right? So at 1,000, that's what this kind of stuff is. 254,000. Strike attack is 20k. Blast attack is 19k, right? That's what all this means. Oh, look at that. Does that mean these characters are actually going to go up to level 9,999? I guess we'll have to wait and see. Again, this is just all assumptions based off of the chart that we're seeing here. The one thing I like about him, and the reason why I think he's so good, is because when you get a green arts card, he heals himself, guys. He will heal himself. And that is very freaking useful. I mean, Broly's definitely going to still have his way with him. But he is actually a really good freaking unit for that. So he heals himself and he cures himself of any status ailments. So you could definitely utilize that for yourself to make it better. So like if someone hits you with a super attack and like you have like a damage inflicted bonus from the enemy, so that way you take more like key blast damage, if you use that card, that will go away. He also has pure evil, 15% minus 15 to own strike arts cost for 10 counts. A strike cost costs 20 normally, so that means your strike costs are only going to be 5. I mean, it's only for 15 timer counts, so if you have all strike cards on there, you could use your main ability. It will drop them all down to 5, launch all of them, hopefully you get a hit, and then, you know, you sit there, you don't even need to charge your key. You can charge your key if you want, but while you're charging your key, you get another round, and hopefully you get some more melees and just use them until the timer goes out. Unique ability, also pretty awesome, plus 20% strike damage inflicted from the battle for 20 timer counts. That's his unique ability, so he gives himself an additional 20% to strike damage. Special ability, obviously, Big Bang Attack, awesome. Deals major explode damage, causes enemies to receive 15% more strike damage for 15 timer counts, so awesome. And extra, Form of Life, restores own health, that's what I was talking about, 15%, yeah. So that's pretty damn freaking epic, you know what I'm saying? Like, that is really awesome. He has a really good unit overall. I really like him. He is a strike-oriented character, by the way. Next one's going to be the Trunks over here. Super Saiyan Trunks Teen. I guess we'll go over here by the thousands instead of doing that. I guess I'm going to have to figure out how I'm going to do these videos when talking about the power levels and whatnot. So his overall power level is 139,000. Health is 240,000. His strike attack's 20,000. Yeah, his strike and his blast are about even. Strike being just a little bit higher than the blast. Strike defense is 16.818. Blast defense is 16.26. Overall, average lower key restore speed, which is very interesting. Let's go over here and just take a look to see if we can see the difference between the two of them. So yeah, Vegeta is better in terms of power, better health. He has strike attack is a little bit less than Trunks is. Trunks' blast attack's a little bit better. Vegeta's defense, obviously, Vegeta's always been a defensive character. At least that's how they've always portrayed him. His strike defense is a lot better than Trunks's, and Trunks's blast defense is better than Vegeta's. So that's pretty awesome, but Vegeta's key restore speed is definitely a lot higher. Let's see over here. Let's slash, stab, shock, explosion. I guess those are the multipliers. Main ability, draw the ultimate arts card, shining slash, 25 timer counts, must elapse. I like those because that's awesome because you get definitely an ultimate, which is also really nice. Unique ability, plus 20% damage inflicted against tag Frieza Force. Cover, reduce damage. He has the Piccolo cover charge. We're going to the bar. Anyway, reduce damage received by 40% until combo ends when changing cover. So if like someone's getting attacked, you could switch into Trunks, and Trunks will reduce the damage taken for the combo up to 40%, well, by 40%. Then he gives himself an additional 10% to own damage inflicted for the first 15 timer counts, but he adds 3 counts to his substitution, which means when you do a swap, you have a little timer about until you can switch back. It adds 3 when you use him for cover. But that's usually outweighed because I think one standard combo like lasts for about 2 seconds, so it's really only 1 second added. Burning attack, major impact damage plus 15% own key recovery for 10 timer counts. That's really awesome. Unfortunately, getting a special is pretty rare. I guess so is the green arts card for Vegeta, but that's pretty awesome. Major damage and 15 to own key. So even if you like miss for some reason, I'm assuming you're still getting that 15% key recovery. Oh, I'm sorry, that's key recovery, not health recovery, but still, 15% key recovery is still awesome. That's 15 key. extra, unlock key form of attack, plus 20% to own strike and blast damage for 20 timer counts. That's actually really awesome. I don't know what the cost of that is. It's probably going to be like 20 or 25, because those are usually pretty, well, a little bit more expensive. since you're doing Strike and Blast attack. I think that was 20 or 25 for Piccolo, I believe it was. Ultimate Special Shining Slash deals major slice damage, inflicts bleed. And that's about it. I'm not going to talk about the friend stuff. So, yeah, all that's here. I'm already pretty far into this video. I'm in this video about 14 minutes right now. So I'm going to go and I'm going to do like the in-game gameplay type stuff in a different video, just so this doesn't drag on a little any longer than it needs to. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. I hope you guys are hyped for this new Dragon Ball Legends stuff. And let me know if you guys summon what you pulled down in the comments below. I don't think I'm going to summon on this just because Vegeta was purchasable. I might do like one or two. I have 4,000 Chrono Crystals, so I might go and do that. If I do, I'll do that in the gameplay. But anyway, guys, thanks for joining me here today, and I'll catch you all later. Peace.